Guys, Phil Dale from Skarnsundet Fjord Centre here. I'm down at Strauman Point now, one of my local marks, 10-15 minutes drive from Skarnsundet. A bit windy and rainy, and I've come shad fishing. So that's a 4-inch computer relaxed shad with a 60-gram jig head, a 10-foot rod, heavy spinning rod, 40 to 80 grams casting weight with a 4000 style fixed spool reel, 20 pound braid. Almost low water now, I'm a little bit late. I'm just gonna have a few casts now. There's still enough current here for there to be fish, so have a few casts and see what happens. First time I've been down here in over a year, so usually it produces quite a few fish. I'm going to keep persisting with the shad at the 60 gram because there isn't a lot of current left, but I'll keep persisting. I'll put the camera back on when I hook into a fish. Well, that was the fourth cast, and a small codling. Took the computer shad. A bit scabbily marked is this one, some scars on it. But yeah, quite a nice codling on a light spinning rod. Bumped another one on the second cast, so four casts, first fish, that's not too bad. I'll get this one chucked back because I'm after a few fish for the table, to be honest, and probably won't take that fish, so I'll get him slipped back and see what else is next. I'm just going to try and run through the technique with you so you can see it, what I'm doing, and all I'm really doing is I'm going to cast out. It's about 10 meters deep, and I'm just going to use the sink and draw technique, very standard for here. So it's just coming to slack water now, so I've probably got another half an hour's worth of fishing. Usually it's a prime time for a big cod to be moving through Strauman on this stage of the tide. Again, just to reiterate on the gear, small breakaway mini link, very strong, very nice, and quite a battered and bruised shad with a 60 gram jig head. 60, 70 or 80 gram jig head is what you want for this type of fishing, and a 4-inch computer shad's perfect. So I hope you can see this on the camera. Got the rod high, let some line out. And as soon as it hits the bottom, start to reel up. bottom, flick it up. Always keep it in contact with the shad. Control of the line with your finger like this. Wait for the jig head to hit the bottom, then immediately get control of the shad. And a quite a fast action rod. Wasn't concentrating. It's a really sensitive way of fishing. Kind of really got to keep in touch before you get stuck on the bottom. It's just long strands of kelp. But you can get some huge cod in here. I've had cod to 28 pounds doing this. Very nice. I lost much bigger ones. It's like 9 meters deep right in front of me. Just as it drops off here. But now quite often the cod are very red in here as well. More like kelp cod, because that's what they're living in, feeding on crabs. couple of strong pulls usually pulls it out. Skarnsundet, I'll come down and show you how to fish like this. And I've got all the gear in the shop, the rods, the reels, the shads. So you really, you don't have to spend all your money. With that lighter line, that thinner braid increases distance no end. It's got a quite a fast actioned rod really. The rods I have are perfect. Show you how to put these on. So there's the shad, there's the jig, through the centre, down, pull, out, push it on, that's enough. But now it's quite slack water, you can kind of pinpoint where you want to cast as well. So I know there's three red sheds in front of me, and usually that seems to be some type of fish holding spot, so now I can start and just kind of precisely cast, and then as soon as you hook a fish on that, you know where you've cast it every time, and as soon as you hook a fish, you know that you can fish there. There's bound to be more fish there because it's a certain fish holding places, you know. All this through here, it's kind of varying between 5, 10, 12 meters deep. There's big holes and gullies, so it's a really interesting place to be fishing. I'll have a few more casts. A 40, 50 yard cast that time. Maybe a bit late in the tide. front tip now. Ah, there's one. Oh, ho, ho! Right under my rock tip. And now I know where I cast it. And I'll try and repeat it. About there. But as that shad comes in now, it'll go right underneath my feet. It's about 5-6 metres deep, just straight out. That was exactly the same spot. Not a big fish. It's good fun on light gear. I'll try and stay here. Usually I'd walk down to land it, but I'll try and stay here so you can see it. It's not so big. But they're really close in.
Really small red fish, hooked straight in the top of the mouth. That's how dark they are. Beautiful cod.
Even catch its mother. So the main thing is really, keep in touch with that shad. As soon as it hits the bottom, maybe you'll see it on the rod tip now. See it when it hits the bottom.
Getting a bit windy and rainy now. Just to run through the gear again, that's a 60 gram a jig head with a VMC Barbarian hook. That's a breakaway mini link, I think it's called. Very strong, you don't need anything bigger, they're tiny. This is a 60 pound leader, it's about a meter and a half of a 60 pound leader onto about 20 pound braid. 4000 or 5000 size fixed bore reel. 10 foot rod, perfect casting weight, 40 to 80 grams. If you want to bring your own gear, if you don't, say I have it all for hire in the shop. I hope you enjoyed that a little bit. And I got wet, had a few fish, and I'm going to go home and looks like I'm having a pizza instead of fish. So thanks for watching.